Hi, this is Lucien, DH7LM, and welcome back to Ham Radio Seoul. So, you're thinking about getting your ham radio license. Awesome, go for it. To help you out, I thought I'd share a couple of things that helped me back when I had to study for my license. And I hope they'll be motivating and helpful for you too. So, tip number one. Understand the material. It may sound obvious, right? But let's face it, many people will just learn the question pool by heart, and that's that. They'll never understand anything. And fair enough. I mean, you probably know by now that the tests are multiple choice and the question pool is public. So theoretically, you can just learn everything by heart and there you go. The problem with that I found is that first of all, you really do need to learn everything by heart if you go that route, right? Because you can't use calculations, you can't use your own understanding of the material to get to the right questions. So it's kind of tedious. You really need to memorize everything. And depending on how good you are with that kind of thing, it might be very frustrating. So my advice would be try to understand at least some of the things, including the technical aspects. It may sound difficult at beginning and you may think, I'm not a technical person and I'm never gonna build my own transceiver anyway. Why do I need all these technical questions? Why do I need to know how to calculate stuff and all that? But think about it this way. First of all, in my own experience, I later realized that I indeed did need many of the things I had to study, including the technical aspects. So it's not really true that you won't need those things, and you never know what kind of topics you're interested in once you have your license, and it's really very worthwhile to understand what's behind all this radio technology. So that's one thing. The other thing is, as I mentioned, it will be much easier to pass the test if you understand the background, really. I mean, of course, you will have to memorize some things and all of that, but if you have a certain understanding, you will just know the right answers to some of the technical questions because you understand it. And even if you don't know them by heart, you can do your own calculations and use your own mind to get to the right answer. So that's awesome. And then, and this is probably the most important thing, for me, it really helped to see the whole process of studying for my license as being a ham, as part of the hobby, right? Because it's easy to think, I'm gonna study for my license, and once I'm licensed, then I'm a ham. Then I can ham it up, right? But that's not true, I think. I think the very process of learning about radio is what hams do, that is being a ham, you know? And you may realize that you can do many things even without a license, like listening to the bands and even do some experiments with transmitting in certain bands and all of that. So the only difference between someone who's licensed and one who is not is that the licensed ham has the right to transmit on the ham bands. Okay, but the hobby is actually much bigger than that. A lot of it has to do with learning about many different things. It doesn't have to be technical, but it often is. But the whole point of the hobby, as far as I'm concerned, is about learning, growing, getting better at things. And this is true whether you entered the hobby because you just want to have fun, or you want to do contests, or even if you're a prepper and just want to be prepared communication wise, or even if you're a sailor who just wants to send emails while on sea. So everywhere it's about learning. It's about learning how to use the equipment, learning what's behind it and all of that. So again, understanding the material is really essential, and it's also a lot of fun because that's what the hobby is about. So that would be my advice. Try to see it as part of the hobby, because you're just doing what hams and licensed hams do all the time, you know, learning stuff. So that's a great mindset, I think. Now, let's be realistic. Most people probably won't understand everything, especially when it comes to the technical aspects. I mean, if you're not an engineer specialized in radio technology, it's hard, you know? So we don't need to get ideological here. Personally, there were some things I really had absolutely no clue about when I studied for my license and when I took the exam, but I just memorized the questions and that's it, right? And I think that it's nothing to be ashamed of, really. I mean, you need to find like a good balance between delving deeper into the material, really understanding it and even enjoying the process, and just, you know, learning some things by heart because you want to pass the test after all, right? So that would be my advice. Find a middle ground and enjoy the process. Number two, consider shooting for a higher license class. I think there are many people who make the mistake that they underestimate their abilities. I mean, passing the exam isn't really that hard. It's not rocket science, really. So the question is, why not go for the higher classes right away? Because what I often see is that people get their entry level license and then they never upgrade. So that's kind of a pity, because I mean, we are all lazy. It's hard to motivate yourself again to do another exam. So it's kind of understandable, but again, another reason to go for the higher class right away. Plus, you may look at it this way. If you are already in the process of studying for your license, it's just a matter of adding another month or something of study, and then you'll be able to do the higher class. Really, it's not more, depending on your time that you have available, of course. But you just, you know, do a couple of extra weeks and there you go. Plus, you don't really have nothing to lose, right? I mean, here in Germany, for example, we have two classes, and you can take the higher class right away. So it's kind of a risk, because if you fail it, you can then, of course, repeat it or do the entry-level class later. But then you kind of failed the test, right? So that's not good. But in the US, as far as I know, maybe I got this wrong, but as far as I know, you can even do consecutive tests in one sitting. So you can do your technician's class and your general and your extra in just one session. So there's really nothing to lose, right? If you go for the extra class even, then even if you fail the general and the extra, you still have your technicians. And obviously, if you're prepared for the extra class, then the technicians class will be a piece of cake, right? Will be easy. So I think it's really good advice to go for the higher classes, and don't underestimate yourself. Don't think you're totally stupid just because you don't have a technical background or anything. It is really doable, really. And for me personally, I've never had anything to do with technology really in a deeper sense, and still I got my highest class, right? So it's doable. So that would be tip number two. Number three, get involved. I mean, there's probably a local ham club around. So talk to the guys, write them an email, join one of their meetings, and have fun. I think this is extremely motivating, because these people are knowledgeable, they're eager to help newcomers. And the best thing maybe is that you can even get some practice. You may even be able to operate a station and get your feet wet. And this is really, really motivating. And you can also kind of connect theory and practice in your mind. And this really, really helps answering those questions. I'm really convinced of that, because once you know how this whole thing works, you know the hem, you know, lingo and the talk and the words and how these guys think, what they say and all of that, it would be so much easier to pass the test. Believe me, it's really worthwhile. And even if you don't want to do that or you don't have a club in your area, at least engage online. There are tons of great email lists, Facebook groups, websites, YouTube videos, resources, what have you, that you can kind of delve into and get a feel what this is all about. Again, it's if you have some experience in the hobby already, it's so much easier to answer all these questions than if you really have no idea whatsoever what this is all about. So that would be a good advice, I think, and this personally helped me also to remember all these things for my exam. Tip number four, listen to the bands. Again, it may sound obvious, but this is something that I, for example, didn't really do, and I regret it, because when you listen to the bands, you can really learn lots and lots and lots about the hobby, about propagation, about how a QSO is conducted, about all these rules, and about especially about all the frequencies, right? Because you do need to memorize them. But if you're used to tuning around on the bands, you will memorize them no problem. So that's really good advice. And you can even buy a transceiver or a shortwave receiver. That would be cool, because then again, you would be already being a ham, basically. You would already practice the hobby, even though you can't transmit. So that's great. And if you don't want to do that, you can still go online and listen to all those web SDR sites. These are basically online receivers that you can just go to on the web, and you listen in real time to what's happening on the various bands. So just Google web SDR and you'll find them. Tip number five, sign up for the exam. Or in other words, you do need a strict time frame if you don't want to risk procrastinating and postponing all the time. And as we all know, a deadline is the best motivator there is. So you'll study extra hard, you'll do all that, you will take the time off to really delve into it once you know that you have a deadline and that you need to keep. So a good way to do it is to just sign up for the exam, right? So then you have some pressure. And I believe that at least in the US, there are even exams where you don't have to sign up, can just walk in. But that's kind of dangerous. So I would suggest that you do a tight plan. You come up with a really tight schedule. So for example, if applicable, you could ask your employer to give you vacation for this specific time frame, or can make other plans that are kind of bit binding, and so that you have some pressure. It's really important. I mean, if you're like me, you work best when under a little pressure. So I would suggest you do that. So that were my five tips. As I said, they greatly helped me get my license. And keep in mind, as I said, I'm not a technical person at all. I don't have a ham dad or anything. I didn't know nothing about the hobby. And still, I passed my highest class the first time I did the exam. It's really not that hard once you change your mindset a little and apply some good tips. And maybe you can even ask other hams to come up with some strategies. As you know, there are all these kinds of apps and online learning software that you can just use to memorize the questions. So it's a lot easier these days to pass the exam. But as I said in the beginning, I think it's very important, very motivating, and makes the whole process much more fun if you try to understand some of the things that you're learning. Yeah. So best of luck to you. I hope we'll get the chance to hear each other on the bands and 73s. Bye-bye.